Some psychics go so far as to offer help to the police. In order to see how useful this is, we prepared an experiment using this collection of instruments, which might have been used to commit crimes. And then again, they might not. Is it possible for a psychic to read the history of an instrument just by touching? My final guest claims to be able to do this. Please welcome Nella Jones. Now, Nella, you regularly approach the police with information you believe you have about crimes. The test you and I have agreed upon involves a number of objects which you've never seen before. We're going to see what information you can get from them. Are these visual images, or do you get sort of an emotional impression, or what is it?
It's sometimes visual. Sometimes it's as if it's an inner knowledge.
But one thing that bothers me now, Suppose you were to handle an item like this, couldn't you perhaps pick up vibrations from the person who sharpened the item, or who perhaps manufactured it, or the person who sold it, and perhaps give wrong information to the police that way?
The police don't often give me tools like this to handle, James. They come along and say, well, we've reached a dead end. Can you throw any light on it whatsoever? And I never say, yes, I'll come and solve the case. I say, I'll do my best.
We have here six different instruments or items or whatever. They all sealed up in plastic bags. Please unwrap them while I explain to the audience what they are. Any or all of these could have been connected with a serious crime involving a loss of life. The history of each object is known. They've been individually wrapped until now to avoid the possibility of psychic contamination. All right, which ones do you think are most likely, then? Let's put it that way.
Well, these three, I felt that's just a little thing. That's just a, I think. Could have been quite innocent, but getting into a lock of some sort. These two, as I say, I felt glass with that one, as if it could have been used to... I feel glass. I just don't know. As I feel it, I'm just picking up glass. Not doing bad, are we? This one, God knows why, I'm picking up a heavy tire, a heavy vehicle tire. So I don't know what that's being used for. Sorry, my darling, best I can do.
Let's look at your results. I know you make no claims for accuracy, but it's still interesting that you examined six objects, you got no information from three of them, and you got incorrect information from the remaining three. I wonder what the police would make of that.
James, you're trying to explain all that I do by logic.
Oh, no.
What I do is illogical.
It's been a most intriguing demonstration, and we'd like to thank you very much, Nella, for taking part. As Nella says, psychics often offer information to help the police with their investigations, and the police acknowledge this, although they say they never approach psychics themselves, and there are no official police psychics. Last August, New Scotland Yard set up a special review to investigate the use of information received from psychics. The police told us there is no recorded instance of psychics solving a criminal case or providing evidence or information which led directly to its solution.